Sister Salah mentioned, the six basic human needs. Once you know that, I think that, and you work on fulfilling your spouse's needs, wants, and fantasies, the desire for your spouse to go out to fulfill them goes down tremendously. One thing I know early on in the marriage, I was 18 when I got married, and he was like, he was 12 years older. He is 12 years older than I am. So anyway, but one thing I knew is he was far more mature than I was and knew so much. He kept making an effort to try and bring me to his level. The books he would read, he would give me to read, and I hated reading. So he would be reading to me, I would close my ears. And we would call it bedtime stories. Over time, I started picking up the books and I started reading them and understanding the things he found interesting. Things to do with world politics, reading the newspaper, watching the news. During his recreation time, what did he spend time watching? Basketball, I knew nothing about it. Football, sometimes. American football, even worse. Baseball and tennis. And I was not interested in sports like that. But I realized that if I wanted him to stay home or go out with me when it's time for sports, I better learn about this. So I asked him to teach me the rules of the game. And that's how one by one he started to help me understand. I became more of a super fan, in fact, than he did. Then other interests that he had. Once you get to identify what are your spouse's love languages, what are their six human needs, and you make a conscious, deliberate effort to fulfill them, like I said, the desire to go out to seek fulfillment elsewhere reduces tremendously. What are his fantasies? What are the things that we women in particular, we would say, you know, it's like muna jinkwinya, or things have to be done in the dark because we are so conscious of ourselves. We body shame ourselves and so on. But he married you as you are. Yes, it's a work in progress. You have to constantly work on maintaining yourself, especially after children. But they also have to do the same. And I think if you are truly committed to a partnership, then all the needs, all the fantasies involving communication to actually know, effective communication, what are the things you enjoy? What are the things that bring you deep pleasure? What are the things that fulfill you? What are your fantasies? And then bring them to life. No kunya in marriage. The final one is feed your spouse's spirit. Sex is important to men, but emotional lovemaking is important to women. For women, they make love emotionally. For men, it has always been said it's sex. However, you can have sex with a prostitute. Physical. It's physical. But why did you get married? It's for something deeper, an emotion. And it is that connection, that dignity that exists in marriage that we all hope to get out of. Like Nuru said, you don't get married to suffer. You're not meant to suffer in marriage. It's meant to be something that allows you to sleep well at night, feeling so fulfilled. A couple of weeks ago, I asked Saeed, what brings you happiness? At what point are you the most at peace with yourself? And he said, the first one is when I do sujood, when I feel I'm closest to Allah. He said, the second is when you are with me. The third is when the children are around or we are connecting with the children. And I said to him, I said, spiritually right now, I'm not as strong as I wish I could be, but I'm working on it. But number one, as I look deep into my soul, what brings me the most pleasure is when I just lie in his arms and I feel so safe, trusting 110% and secure. So I want to emphasize, how did we build what we have today? Where I really do still sometimes have my heart skip a beat when I see him, is because we have committed to fulfilling all the needs. His friends make fun of him, that yena purda, because he doesn't come out and hang out with friends. In fact, we have become so antisocial. Friends don't come to our house. We are each other's best friend. And that's where we find the most fulfillment, peace, and happiness. And for me, that's what I will advise you. Build this. Yeah.